I'll start by creating a new web project. It's going to be running on Glassfish 4. And I'm going to create an endpoint server demo. And it's gonna extend javax.websocket.endpoint since I'm gonna be implementing programmatic WebSocket endpoint here. And this is gonna be the package. And I'm also gonna need a message handler demo, which is gonna implement the message handler dot hole. Type is going to be string, and by implementing that interface I'm going to have to implement the onMessage method. So when a complete message arrives, the onMessage is going to be invoked. Now if the message is received in parts, the container is going to buffer that message until it fully receives the whole message, and then this method is gonna get called. And I'm also gonna have a server application config demo class that's gonna be implementing the server application config interface. And by implementing that interface, I'm gonna have these two methods: get annotated endpoint classes and get endpoint configs. And here I'm gonna be using this one, the endpoint configs. Also gonna create the client, which is gonna be an HTML page. Now going to the server application config demo. I'm gonna start here by creating a hash set that is gonna contain the server endpoint configs that I'm gonna be returning. So I'm gonna return that hash set, but before returning it, I'm gonna go ahead and create a server endpoint config and add it to the set. And that server endpoint config that I'm gonna create it, I'm gonna do it through server endpoint config.builder.create, the static create method. And I'm gonna pass in the endpoint server demo class, so this class, and I'm also gonna pass in where how it's going to be accessed. So it's going to be accessed by your project name slash endpoint server demo. Now going to the endpoint server demo, I'm gonna have a static set that is gonna contain the chat room users, the chat room user sessions. Let me change the naming here to session and endpoint config. So when I have a WebSocket open event, I'm gonna start by picking up the session from here and adding it to the chat room users. And I also need to specify the message handler that I'm going to be using, which is going to be this guy, message handler demo. So I'm going to do session.add message handler, and I'm going to instantiate the message handler demo passing in the session. So I don't have that constructor yet here. So let me set an instance variable user session or session, and I'm gonna be setting that session in the constructor. So passed in session, and this dot user session is session. Now the endpoint on open method is an abstract method that has to be implemented by classes that extend from endpoint. I have two other methods that I'm gonna have here that are optional methods that can be implemented. I mean, they don't have to be implemented like on open, since they're not abstract in endpoint. So onClose, when a WebSocket close events happen, and onError when an error happens. So all what I'm gonna do when an error happens is to print the stack trace. And on the onClose, what I'm gonna be doing is to remove the session from the chat room users. And still need to implement some additional functionality on the onClose. And I'm gonna go to the previous project, so WebSocket project 04, and I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna need these three functions. I don't want to re-implement them since they're gonna be exactly the same, so I'm gonna copy them from here and close this guy. And I'm gonna put them in endpoint server demo. And I'm gonna make them static and public. And now on the onClose event, I can update the various users that this user has exited the chat room. So I'm gonna iterate through all the sessions in the chat room users and send them a text. I'm gonna use endpoint server demo dot build JSON user data. So it's gonna give me back a string, a JSON string of all the users that are in that chat room. Next, I can go to the message handler demo. And let me change this to message. And the first thing I'm gonna try to do is to pick up the username. I'm gonna use the user session that I initialized in the constructor. And if the username is null, it means I haven't set the username yet, so this is the first time the user is trying to connect. And the first message is gonna be the username, so I'm gonna use user session dot get user properties dot put username and the message. And the system is gonna send a message to that user informing him that he's just connected, so you are connected as and the username. And I need to update the various users with the fact that this new user has entered the room, so I'm gonna iterate through all the chat room users and sending them. Gonna use endpoint server demo dot build JSON user data. So the user set display is gonna update. It's gonna get updated. Those various users. And in case that user has logged in before, what I'm gonna do is to broadcast the message to the various users. And I have too many try catches to this. And next, let me go and do the client side. So default.html. It's gonna be the title. I'm gonna have a messages text area and a users text area next to it, and a message input text field, and a send button that is gonna trigger the send message JavaScript function. And I'm gonna have this JavaScript code here. And I'm gonna start by picking up a WebSocket, and the browser that I've been using is the Chrome browser, the latest version. So I'll pick up a messages text area, and when this client receives a message, gonna be handled in the process message function. So WebSocket.onMessage, and I'm gonna start by parsing the incoming message. So JSON.parse, I have the JSON data here, and I have two cases. The message is gonna be either a user's message or it's gonna be a message. So if it is a chat message, I'm gonna go ahead and update the messages text area with that message. Otherwise, I'm gonna update the users text area with the various users. So I'm gonna do a while loop on the JSON data dot users. Now when the user clicks the send button, the send message function is gonna be triggered. So I have a send message function where I'm gonna send the content of the text message and then clear it out. And when the user closes the browser, I want to be able to close the socket. So what I'm gonna do is pick up windows.onBeforeUnload, and in that case I'm gonna disable WebSocket closing dot onClose, and then I'm gonna trigger a WebSocket dot close event. And in that case, what's gonna happen is the onClose here is gonna be triggered. So I'm gonna be removing that session from the chat room users and then broadcasting the updated. Next, let me go ahead and test run this application. But before doing that, I'm gonna set the default browser as Chrome.